Hello, I'm Emma Kuster, Program Coordinator of the South Central Climate Science Center. In this video, I'll be discussing the impacts of climate change on rural communities, like that of my hometown in Arkansas. Over 95% of the U.S. land area is classified as rural, but this does not only include agricultural lands. Other rural areas include small towns with a tourism-based economy or energy development-based economy. National parks are also considered rural lands in the United States. Urban dwellers receive many of the amenities they enjoy from rural locations, such as food, energy, water, and recreational activities. Climate change is and will continue to challenge many rural communities. Since rural communities are less economically diverse than their urban counterparts, it is often much harder for these communities to adapt to the changes brought on by global climate change. Tourism, forestry production, and agriculture have all been impacted by changes in season length, temperature, and precipitation patterns, and severe weather events. Rural communities in the mountains face unique challenges due to decreased snowpack, and those along the coast face unique challenges due to sea level rise. The impacts of climate change will not be uniform across all areas. In fact, some areas could benefit from shifts in season timing, temperatures, and precipitation. For example, some producers may even benefit from longer growing seasons. The economic development of rural communities, including tourism, agriculture, and forestry, rely on natural resources that are affected by climate change. For example, more frequent and severe droughts have affected rural economies by decreasing crop yields and reducing viable livestock. According to NOAA's National Centers for Environmental Information, $24 billion drought events have resulted in an estimated loss of $226 billion in the U.S. since 1980. To put this in perspective, these drought events have caused the second highest amount of dollar losses in the U.S. since 1980. Communities that rely on forestry production or tourism associated with forested national parks have battled the negative impacts of increasing wildfires. Fire suppression, coupled with more frequent and intense drought conditions, has resulted in a buildup of dry fuel loads. When burned, these fuel loads burn hotter and impact the landscape more severely. Since 1980, there have been $14 billion wildfire events. While fewer than 7% of American workers are directly employed by the agriculture sector, more than 40% of the land in the United States is occupied by farmland. Many farmers are already adapting their practices to fit a changing climate, including shifting cropping patterns and changing the timing in which they plant and harvest their crops. While longer growing seasons may prove beneficial to some crop types, declines in the number of frost days could result in early blooms that are damaged by late season frost. Rural communities with farming-based economies are switching to amenity-based economies, attempting to adapt to the already existing economic struggles. As a result, natural amenities and infrastructure in rural communities such as roads that are already vulnerable to flooding risk have become increasingly stressed. Increased erosion and maintenance costs resulting from increasing tourism and hotter temperatures will continue to be an economic burden for rural communities. Disruptions to the already limited transportation network in rural communities due to flooding and extreme heat associated with climate change will also deeply affect the rural economy. Rural communities are characterized by higher poverty rates than other areas, with an older population and higher unemployment. We often see an outflux of youth in the rural workforce as they seek more diverse job opportunities in the cities. The isolated nature of rural communities is another factor that increases their vulnerability to extreme events. Power and communication outages often take longer to repair, and the lack of cellular coverage creates an additional issue for disaster response. Furthermore, governments in rural areas are generally ill-prepared to effectively address large-scale events. Because of these factors, many rural communities are more vulnerable to climate change than urban areas. Rural communities can lead adaptation efforts so that their citizens and economic drivers are more resilient to climate change, but they need the resources to do so. Rural communities will need assistance in assessing their risk and vulnerabilities, prioritizing and coordinating projects, and developing and sharing decision support tools. In order for adaptation measures to be effective, they will need to be location-specific, driven by the needs of the local stakeholders.